Greetings. Recently, I wanted to study some of the unfulfilled prophecies in the Bible. Another one I want to examine is the two witnesses of Revelation. Revelation 11:3, "And I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days clothed in sackcloth. These are the two olive trees and the two candlesticks standing before the God of the earth. And if any man will hurt them, fire proceeds out of their mouth and devours their enemies. And if any man will hurt them, he must in this manner be killed. These have the power to shut heaven, that it rain not in the days of their prophecy, and have power over waters to turn them to blood, and to smite the earth with all plagues as often as they will. And when they shall have finished their testimony, the beast that ascends out of the bottomless pit shall make war against them, and shall overcome them and kill them. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. And they of the people and kindreds and tongues and nations shall see their dead bodies 3 days and a half, and shall not suffer their dead bodies to be put in graves. And they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them and make merry, and shall send gifts one to another, because these two prophets tormented them that dwell on the earth. And after 3 days and a half, the Spirit of life from God entered into them, and they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon them which saw them. And they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, Come up hither. And they ascended up to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them." This is certainly a fantastical description of what these two witnesses do. In the church, there are several theories about who these two witnesses are. Personally, I believe Enoch and Elijah, but who they are is a minor point. I am going to be watching for two men who will be suddenly on the scene and active for a set time. Revelation 11:3, "And I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days, clothed in sackcloth." 1,260 days. If a year was 360 days, this would be exactly 3.5 years. At 365 days a year, it is just shy of exactly 3.5 years. And the Jewish calendar is lunar based. It uses a month that is 29 or 30 days, and the number of months can change from year to year. So a year in the Jewish calendar is not always 360 days either. There may be some who attempt to prove a year is 360 days just to get this to fit with half of the tribulation. I'm not convinced this is an appropriate situation to try and ramrod into the prophecy. So rather than try to force 1260 days to have some hyper-spiritualized meaning, let's restrain from claiming it is something other than a length of time. Moving on, they will be in Israel, and specifically in Jerusalem, because Jerusalem is literally ground zero of the last days. These men will speak in public. "And if any man will hurt them, fire proceedeth out of their mouth and devours their enemies." These men will defend themselves with fire. Now, I'm sure some of you liberal-minded religious types are spasming in your seats. You have been taught there are no such thing as supernatural miracles. You see out of their mouths in the text, and the only thing you can rationalize is words. You want to read this fire as a metaphor for good arguments. Arguments so undeniable and irrefutable they are as if they were on fire, or some other dismissive and disbelieving nonsense from your secular mind. But if you do, you are in serious danger, brother. In these last days, the supernatural will become more common. And Satan's minion Issa of Islam will perform signs and wonders. Matthew 24:24, for there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. You need to decide if you love the truth so much that you will embarrass your pseudo-intellectual self in pursuit of the truth. Moving on. These have power to shut heaven, that it rain not in the days of their prophecy, and have power over waters to turn them to blood, and to smite the earth with all plagues as often as they will. As often as they will. It's their decision. These men will cause a drought. So I'll be looking for a drought in the Middle East. Drought in the Middle East, you ask? Right. It is already a desert, but I expect it will be so severe it will get news attention. I also expect other interesting events, namely plagues, to be reported. I expect these two men to speak Hebrew, as they are witnesses to Israel about God. And when they shall have finished their testimony, they have a purpose, they have a message, and nothing will shut them up until they have completed their task. And when they shall have finished their testimony, the beast that ascended out of the bottomless pit shall make war against them, and shall overcome them and kill them. Watch for these two men specifically to be killed. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. So this means Jerusalem, and their bodies will be left in the street. And they of the people and kindreds and tongues and nations shall see their dead bodies 3 days and a half, and shall not suffer their dead bodies to be put in graves. Dead in the street for 3.5 days. And they that dwell upon the earth shall rejoice over them and make merry. The people rejoice at their deaths, probably because the plagues and drought stop when they die. And the people of the world have time to celebrate it, 3.5 days. They give gifts to each other during this 3.5 days. Revelation 11:10, and shall send gifts one to another. Because these two prophets tormented them that dwell on the earth. Because these two prophets tormented them that dwell on the earth. And after 3 days and a half, the Spirit of life from God entered into them. And they stood upon their feet, and great fear fell upon them which saw them. These two men will be resurrected. This event will be witnessed. It will cause fear in those that see it. And they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, come up hither. And they ascended up to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them. Now, some try to hyper-spiritualize the two witnesses. I've seen teachings that these two are the Old and New Testament, or the Jews and the Christians. But I think the only way to respect a prophecy is to respect all of it. The interpretation must include all of the points of the prophecy. Metaphorical interpretations typically do not make sense for the whole description of the prophecy. In fact, I cannot recall a single metaphorical explanation I have read that handles all the points of this prophecy of the two witnesses. So for now, I am patiently looking for the literal fulfillment of these two witnesses. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.